हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ लता नरवानी फ्रॉम माउंट लिट्रा जी स्कूल झांसी. चिल्ड्रन, वी वर डिस्कसिंग द प्रॉपर्टीज़ ऑफ मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. लास्ट टाइम वी हैड डिस्कस्ड रिएक्शन ऑफ मेटल्स विद ऑक्सीजन. टुडे वील डिस्कस सम मोर रिएक्शंस. सो फर्स्ट इज़ रिएक्शन विद वाटर. डिफरेंट मेटल्स रिएक्ट डिफरेंटली विद वाटर. मीन्स in the reactivity series, the metals which are placed at the top, like sodium and potassium, they can react very vigorously even with cold water. Then come magnesium and calcium. They also can react with cold water, but the reaction is not vigorous. Then comes aluminium and zinc. Aluminium and zinc, they require hot water. And after that comes iron. Iron cannot react with hot water, it requires steam for the reaction. So meaning to say that different metals, they react differently under different conditions with water. So let us see how does various metals, they react with water. First, sodium and potassium, they react vigorously, means at a very high speed, with cold water only. So they form corresponding hydroxides and hydrogen gas is liberated. The reactions can be given as 2Na plus 2H2O gives 2NaOH plus H2. Similarly, 2K plus 2H2O gives 2KOH plus H2. Hydroxides are formed and hydrogen gas is formed. The reaction is very violent and exothermic, that the hydrogen gas catches fire and leads to explosion. Second type of reaction, calcium. When calcium reacts, it also can react with cold water only. But here, the reaction is not so violent as in case of sodium and potassium. So calcium hydroxide is formed and hydrogen gas is formed, but the reaction is less violent or slow. Reaction is Ca plus 2H2O gives CaOH twice plus H2. The piece of calcium starts floating after some time, because the bubbles of hydrogen gas produced, they stick to the surface of calcium. Third type of reactions, where magnesium and zinc, they react with hot water. Now hot water is required for the reaction. Mg plus 2H2O gives MgOH twice plus H2. Similarly, zinc also reacts with boiling water. Zn plus H2O gives ZnOH twice plus H2O. Next, aluminium and iron. Aluminium also can react with boiling water, but iron, it does not even react with hot or boiling water. So still severe conditions are required for iron to react with water. So water is taken in the form of steam, and iron reacts with the steam only when it is heated until red hot. So when steam is passed over red hot iron, then only the reaction occurs. The reaction is 3Fe plus 4H2O gives Fe3O4 plus 4H2. This Fe3O4 is named as iron 2-3 oxide, and it is a mixture of FeO plus Fe2O3. Metals like copper, silver and gold, which come below hydrogen in the reactivity series, they do not react with water even under very strong conditions. Means whatever conditions we take, whether hot water, boiling water, steam, these reactions, they don't react with water under any conditions. So we can conclude that the reactivity order of metals is sodium is more reactive than magnesium, which is more reactive than aluminium, which is more reactive than zinc, then iron, and lastly copper. Now next reaction is the reaction of metals with acids. Metals react with dilute acids and liberate hydrogen gas. As we have seen in case of water, hydroxide is formed and hydrogen is formed. In the same way, when metal reacts with dilute acid, corresponding salts are formed and hydrogen gas is liberated. So again, different metals, they react with different E's. So first of all, sodium, magnesium, calcium. Sodium, magnesium and calcium, they react violently with dilute HCl or H2SO4. Means the reaction is very fast. 2Na plus 2HCl gives 2NaCl plus H2. Mg plus H2SO4 gives MgSO4 plus H2. Ca plus 2HCl gives CaCl2 plus H2. We saw that in first case sodium chloride is formed, then magnesium sulfate is formed, then calcium chloride is formed. And in all cases, hydrogen gas is liberated. Now, no reaction occurs with dilute nitric acid, dilute HNO3, because it is an oxidizing agent, so it breaks down into H2O plus NO. Next is reaction with zinc and aluminium. So when metals like zinc and aluminium, they react with acids like dilute HCl or dilute H2SO4, the reaction is not very fast, but still it is fast. So first case, Zn plus HCl forms ZnCl2 plus H2. Then 2Al plus 3H2SO4 forms Al2SO4 thrice plus H2. Zinc chloride and hydrogen is formed. In second case, aluminium sulfate and hydrogen is formed. Now, how does iron react with acids? Iron reacts slowly. The rate is going on decreasing. Fe plus 2HCl forms FeCl2, ferrous chloride plus hydrogen. Fe plus H2SO4 gives ferrous sulfate, FeSO4 plus hydrogen. Then comes copper. Copper does not react with dilute HCl or dilute H2SO4 at all. Means Cu plus HCl, no reaction. Copper plus H2SO4, no reaction occurs. Means copper is very less reactive than iron, so it does not react with any of the acid under any conditions. So again, the reaction of metals and acids also show us that sodium is very much reactive, and which is more reactive than magnesium. Magnesium is more reactive than aluminium, which is more reactive than zinc, and then iron, and then copper. So children, this is all for today. Thank you.